18 foods that could become extinct. With the Earth's core temperature rising due to global warming caused by the emission and entrapment of greenhouse gases, the planet's climate is being thrown all out of whack. It's even beginning to affect how we produce crops. From the caffeine rush of coffee to the creamy sweet goodness of chocolate, here are 18 foods that could potentially go extinct in our lifetime. Durum wheat. Pasta lovers will be disheartened to know that pasta itself is in danger of meeting the same fate as the saber-toothed tiger. Since global warming is a very real thing that is currently affecting our planet, the production of durum wheat is being severely affected. Durum wheat is used in creating a number of delicious pasta, and it's being said by researchers that the species of wheat will begin its gradual decline in the next 2 years and will be completely gone by the end of our lifetime. Stone fruits. It was back in 2016 when a handful of states in the Northeast, including Rhode Island, New York, and New Jersey, were all hit with a warm month in winter and then two brutal cold snaps. The warming temperature caused all stone fruit trees to flower much too early, and then the cold snaps ended up decimating the premature crops. Cherries, nectarines, and peaches were among the fruits that were all affected. Local farmers went on to predict that the likelihood of this same catastrophe happening again is pretty high. Strawberries. Summers will never be the same again with the extinction of the strawberry. As of right now, they should be labeled as endangered, since strawberry farms in both Florida and California are yielding much lower numbers than is standard. Strawberries are a winter fruit that flourish in chilly weather, so all of this summer heat is causing the plants to have delayed flowerings, or no flowering at all. Should this trend continue on the same trajectory in the decades to come, then strawberries could potentially be no more. Rice. Rice is a staple grain that is consumed all over the world and plays a huge part in keeping those who fall under the poverty line fed. It's recognized as accounting for 51% of the world's caloric intake, and the demand for it is only going to get higher. The demand is scheduled to rise by 33% by the year 2050. Croplands, where rice grows, are under attack due to the unpredictable nature of the weather and could one day become barren and obsolete. Soybeans. A computer simulation carried out by a group of scientists from the Potsdam Institute for Climate Impact Research revealed how different crops of significant importance respond to rising temperatures. The findings obviously didn't have the best of news. One of those crops is soybeans, and the data showed that by the year 2100, it has the potential to drop by 40%. This might not seem like a pretty big deal since it won't affect most of us now, but believe me, it is a big deal, considering it is an excellent source of biofuels. It's also the base for important foods such as tofu, tempeh, and miso. Maple syrup. Harvesting maple syrup is a lot more intricate than one would expect it to be, and a big portion of it has to do with how the weather itself is doing. In order for the sap of the maple tree to be extracted, it has to first be able to properly flow. This is where the weather plays its part. Once temperatures are warm enough during the day, the sap will flow, and at night, the sap will sink into the tree once temperatures get below freezing. This drop in temperature is what lets the sap flow out of the tree when it's being collected. The warmer change in weather is already affecting the maple syrup industry and will gradually continue to do so. Coffee. Coffee lovers might want to tune in for this next one, or maybe leave in denial. Because of global warming and the Earth getting dangerously warmer and warmer each year, coffee might no longer be around in the next generation's lifetime. That's right, no more Starbucks and all-nighters. It's being predicted by researchers that by the year 2080, all wild coffee beans will officially be wiped from this earth. It's not just the warmer weather that is doing the job, but local fungi and pests will speed up the process as well. French fries. Back in 2015, an article published by Vice News revealed that the great vegetable that is the potato is facing dire cultivation issues. Due to climate change, farmers down in Peru are having to uproot their crops and plant them at a higher elevation to avoid the rising surface temperatures. Peru happens to be the home of over thousands of different potato species that are grown locally and is the epicenter for potatoes. Experts say that the farmers won't be able to keep moving their crops higher, and in about 40 years, will run out of time. Honey. The sweet golden nectar's future has been up in the air for what seems like forever. The whole ordeal that is going on with the bee population is incredibly alarming, and why it's not being taken more seriously and publicized in the media is beyond belief. Honeybees' numbers have been dropping like flies thanks to CCD, or honeybee colony collapse disorder. For the last 10 years, more than 40% of the population has dropped, to be exact. That's more than one-third of the entire population of America. Basically, CCD results in most of the worker bees in a hive just getting up and disappearing from the colony. This leaves the queen behind with a few nurse bees that take care of the younger ones. Pumpkins. There might possibly come a time that carving a jack-o'-lantern on a pumpkin will just be a distant memory. Not only that, but you'll have to find a different side to serve at Thanksgiving, as pumpkin pies will be out of the question. Like with honey, the production of pumpkins all falls down on the tiny shoulders of bees. And it's not just pumpkins, as plenty of other crops rely on the pollination of bees to bear fruit. Without bees, no pumpkins. Plain and simple. Almond milk. With an increase in individuals turning to a non-dairy inclusive diet, dairy alternatives such as almond milk have become increasingly popular with the masses. This means that the production of almonds must also increase in order to meet supply and demand. The state of California yields approximately 2.1 billion pounds of almonds annually, but that's all likely to change due to the state experiencing warmer winters and harsh periods without rain. This is a huge issue, as California also happens to supply 82% of the world's demand for almonds. Wine grapes. Because of the Earth's temperature becoming increasingly warm, places like California are being hit with an extended amount of time without experiencing any rainfall at all. This means that regions such as Sonoma and Napa are finding it difficult to grow the grapes that make their signature wines. The grapes actually enjoy heat, but they've been getting way more than they like, and so they end up dying off before they're ready to be picked. This also happens to be the case in France. Places like the American Midwest and the United Kingdom are having no issue with the temperature change, but it's only a matter of time. Chocolate. Could you possibly imagine what it would be like to live in a world where chocolate does not exist? Well, no need to envision that bleak future, because we're already on the way there. Due to the weather warming up and persistent droughts, the sweet treat might be gone for good if nothing is done. Experts have predicted that by the year 2050, chocolate would be completely wiped off the face of the Earth. That's only 32 years from now. The problem is being accelerated even faster, since more and more people are starting to prefer dark chocolate, as it is the healthiest form of chocolate, but it does take more cocoa to make. Peanuts. First chocolate, and now peanut butter? Life is officially canceled. Sadly, it's true. Peanut plants are having a tremendously tough time yielding crops, as they do need to have a specific and constant climate to grow, which make them pretty fickle to begin with. Here in the United States, peanuts are mostly grown in the southern states, but it's here that the temperatures are getting the warmest and where the most droughts are occurring. It's been estimated that by the year 2030, the world could be without peanuts. Scary thing is, that's only 12 years away. Bananas. History has unfortunately decided to repeat itself, but that's what ultimately will happen to those who never learn, and the rest of us have to pay the price. During the 1940s, the Gros Michel banana was the main variety of banana that was sold in North America and Europe, and then the crop began to die off. This wasn't due to climate change though, but rather a nasty fungus was the culprit at fault. Panama disease was the name given to it, and what it does is constrict the roots of the banana tree and ends up suffocating the fruit. The Cavendish, which is what we all eat today, was then introduced and replaced the Gros Michel. Unfortunately, a new strain of the fungus called Tropical Race 4 is threatening to wipe out the Cavendish species. Fish. At the rate humans are catching fish, the world might not have any in a handful of decades. This is because fishermen happen to be catching them way faster than the fish are able to reproduce, resulting in an unsustainable commodity. The depletion of fish populations is being monitored closely, and researchers state that potentially by the year 2050, we might not have any fish left if we continue down the same self-destructive path. Species like the salmon rely on cold waters in order to spawn, but with global warming creating much warmer waters, the population is steadily thinning. Those of you who enjoy sushi should also cut down on your consumption, as the bluefin tuna is the sixth most endangered fish on the planet. chickpeas. Fans of hummus should definitely be concerned that chickpeas, or garbanzo bean, is also having its fair share of troubles. Chickpeas require very large amounts of water in order to grow, and just a single ounce will need about 76 gallons of water. To put that into perspective, one can of chickpeas holds 15 ounces. Droughts that are occurring all over the world have diminished the chickpea production all the way down as much as 40 to 50%. You better stock up on them while you can, as the legume's foreseeable future is an unpredictable one at the moment. There's another particular dip that is also in the danger zone. Avocados. Yes, it's true. This famous fruit is in the works of eventually becoming a thing of the past. And no, it's not because millennials are ordering extra guac on the side. Like we previously stated, the Earth's warming temperatures are having a severe effect on the climate of certain areas. Most of the avocados that grow in the United States are grown in California, where the state experienced a more severe drought than usual back in 2017. It's no easy task cultivating avocados, as just one requires approximately 9 gallons of water, and a pound needs 72 gallons. If these conditions keep heading down the same path, production will severely slow down and eventually might stop. At least millennials will finally be able to afford houses. So what's something you learned today that you didn't already know? Let us know down in the comments section below, and while you're there, don't forget to subscribe to see more awesome videos just like this.